Hello everybody and welcome to another video. Today we're going to go over assignment 5 and assignment 6. So assignment 5 is titled Boring Sentences. In this assignment we're going to go over how to make a boring sentence interesting. So let's start off with a boring sentence. I bought shoes. So there are two ways that you can make boring sentences interesting. The first way is through adding detail. And where we add some adjectives or we answer questions such as who bought the shoes, why did they buy the shoes, what type of shoes, when did they buy the shoes, what color are the shoes. By adding detail to a sentence, it creates more interest for the reader. So let's ask those questions. Let's first ask, what type of shoes? Let's say we bought new sandals. Next one. Why did you buy new sandals? Let's say it's summer now and all of my old sandals are broken. So I bought new sandals because it's now summer and my old sandals are broken. Next we can ask, where did you buy sandals? Let's see, I went to the mall and bought sandals. So I went to the mall and I bought new sandals there. What else can we add? Oh, you know what else we can add? Color. What color were the sandals? I like blue, so I bought blue sandals. All right, I think that's enough detail for us to make a new sentence. So what we're gonna do is all of this new detail that we added, we're going to add that into our original sentence. Okay, let's write our new sentence. Let's underline. All right. So let's start off with I went to the mall. I went to the mall and bought new blue sandals because it's summer and all my old sandals are broken. So see how much more we added to that sentence? Now the reader has so much more detail as to why this person bought shoes. Now the next step that we can do is word choice. Word choice is reconsidering the words that you already have and replacing them with more interesting words or fun words or more descriptive words. So let's try that. So let's pick out some words. So let's start off with mall. Let's make that a proper noun by naming the mall. So I went to the Otinoki Mall. What else can we add? Bought. Let's replace that with purchased. It's a bigger word. It sounds a little more fancy, so why not? Next word. Let's do sandals. My favorite type of sandals are flip-flops, so let's put that. Now let's do broken. I'm sure we can find a new word for broken. Let's say falling apart. Falling apart gives me a better idea of what's happening with this old sandals. So I think that's good enough. So now what we're going to do is just take these new words that we picked and add them into our sentence that we already made. All right, so I went to the Otinoki Mall and purchased new blue flip-flops because it's summer and all my old sandals are falling apart. We went from I bought shoes to I went to the Otinoki Mall and purchased new blue flip-flops because it's summer and all my old sandals are falling apart. Just by adding some more detail, now the reader has so much more information about why I bought sandals. So what you're going to do is you're going to do the same process to 4 sentences in your package. So now let's go over assignment 6, which is your final part to your writing project. And here we are writing the conclusion paragraph. So your conclusion paragraph to your writing project is the final paragraph in your essay that wraps up your project. It lets the reader know that the essay has come to a close. So this is the structure of the essay that you wrote. We started off first with an introduction paragraph, and then we had 3 body paragraphs, And now we're ending with a conclusion. It's shaped like a little candy. Isn't it so cute? I made it myself. The introduction paragraph is shaped like this little triangle because we start off broad in our introduction paragraph, and then we target what our essay is going to be about. So the body is the biggest part of this diagram because that's where we get all of the detail about what that essay is about. And then the conclusion, which is what we're doing now, it's like the opposite of the introduction. We go into our conclusion paragraph, and what we do is we wrap up the essay. And essentially, we're basically kind of repeating everything that we said in the body. We repeat exactly what the essay was about. So in this case, we wrote about what you missed about life before the coronavirus and what you plan to do once life returns back to normal. So you'll repeat that, and then you add some main details that you wrote about in the body, and then you wrap it up with a broad sentence. So let's look at the example paragraph that you see on your sheet. Let's read it. There are so many things to do during the summer. Of all the different activities I can do, riding my bike and having barbecues are my most favorite. I especially love doing these activities with my friends and family. Now that it is almost summer, I can't wait to do all my favorite summer activities every single day. So this was just one conclusion paragraph that I made up and added to your sheet as an example. Just from this one conclusion paragraph, you have an idea of what that whole essay would have been about. We know what the essay was about. It was about my favorite things to do in the summer. I included a couple things that were my most favorite, which are riding my bike and having barbecues. And I also included that I like to do with friends and family. And then I wrapped it up with a closing sentence. This can sometimes be the hardest part about writing a conclusion paragraph, is wrapping it up in a nice sentence that feels like the story is now finished. So this is what you're going to do for your writing project. Remember, you wrote about what you miss about life before the coronavirus and what you plan to do once life returns back to normal. Include a couple details that you wrote about and then make a nice finishing sentence, and then you're done. And once you're finished that, your final thing is the test, and it just covers everything that we went over in this package, and then you're done your final package. So give it a go and let me know if you need any help. I hope you enjoyed all of these videos. I had a lot of fun making them. And you're almost done. Good job, and we'll see you around. Bye!